process through YouTube and everything like that, so because it's a longer video, I graded every NBA draft pick of the first round. It took a while, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it. So if you missed out on it, if it was too late of an upload, make sure you guys go check it out right now. It was a lot of fun. Also, again, thank you guys so much for the constant support. You guys are just going just above and beyond, and I really appreciate you guys. I really do appreciate the people who are emailing me about personal videos. If you do want a personal video where I can do a specific role play, talk about a specific team, player, play a game for you, and do ASMR on it, anything at all you guys want, make sure you email me. Email and everything is down in the description. It's a lot of fun to do those for you guys, and I really appreciate the people who do that, because it just makes you, it really goes above and beyond, and I really do like love it so much. Obviously everything I do and get from that goes right back into the channel, getting games, money for pack openings, different things here and there, and I really do appreciate it. So again, thank you guys so much for doing that. Also, if you do like this video, make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel. We're almost at 5k. We're so close to 5k. So if you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe to the channel. I would really appreciate that as well. Now, let's jump right into the video. And in today's video, we're going just to be talking about video games. Now, I really wanted to do more video gaming content on this channel. It's been a while. I think the last sort of gaming video I did on this channel was the Halloween event for Call of Duty, which was obviously in October. So it's been a while. I've obviously done like 2K stuff, but it wasn't really like gameplay stuff. It was just, you know, I did a really nice pack opening and some 2K rebuilds for teams, but for gaming videos, I obviously have some things in mind, and we're just going to be talking about video games today, so I'm sure everyone sort of has a nice interest in video games who are watching this video. But I guess I could just talk about, you know, new video games coming out that I would like to play, video games that are out right now that I like to play, video games I have been playing a lot of, and obviously the infamous new consoles that I will probably never get my greedy hands on ever. No, but yeah, I guess we can start talking about those things. I guess the first thing we can talk about are the new consoles. Yes, I could sort of just give a sort of my opinion on the new consoles and things like that. If you do have a PS5 or an Xbox Series X or whatever the other one is called, I forget the mini Xbox, you know, the one that's not the more expensive one, let me know your guys' experiences on them. From what I've seen very little. I really want to keep it like new to myself, so when I actually get one, it's like oh wow, this is fun sort of surprise type of thing. But I also want to know if it's good or not, or worth it or not. So let me know down in the comments if you guys think it's worth it or not. I would really like to know that. But yeah, I've been planning on getting a PS5, and I think everything on the PS5 looks really nice. I really like the sort of home sort of screen they have going on for the PS5 that I've definitely seen. Startup time for games look really good. Looks like you can jump around from game to main menu to game to, you know, a different game very quickly, and I think that's awesome. I'm not someone who does a lot of that. When I like sit down and play a video game, I'm like gonna sit down and play a video game, not like bounce around to a bunch of different games, unless I'm in a party or something like that with like a friend, then maybe we'll do that. But I'm usually someone who really likes to just stick to the game and sort of play it out, and yeah, so that seems pretty fun. Obviously the graphics look absolutely insane. Now I know people always talk about how you need a 120Hz TV to really see a difference, and I think the TV I have has that, so I'm really excited about that. 4K TV, everything like that, so I'm like, I'm definitely ready to see, you know, the sort of increase in graphics and how the screen and everything looks. I'm very excited about that. I'm not really sure. I'm sure as games go on and progress, the graphics will look even more and more crazy. I know obviously with the PS4 first coming out, I had it pretty early on. It's definitely not like nowadays. I feel like the PS4 is pretty easy to get when it first was coming out, but PS5 is gonna be tough. I don't think I may not even get one until maybe like after the new year. Honestly, it's gonna start to look like that. But I know when 2K14 came out with the PS4, that game was a humongous jump head over heels over, you know, head and shoulders above the PS3 version of that game. everything is just sort of different compared to current gen to next gen, just how like in the PS3 version to the PS4 version. I'm very excited about that. Yeah, and I'm sure the Xbox is sort of the same way. I haven't had an Xbox obviously since the Xbox 360, so it's definitely been a while. Not because I just haven't, you know, been a fan of Xbox. Obviously, Xbox was, everybody and their mom had an Xbox 360 at some point in time, and it's just one of the best consoles I've ever made. But when it comes to just Xbox versus PlayStation, I actually originally was getting a PS4 / a PS3 because I am a humongous fan of Kingdom Hearts. It's my favorite game series of all time. Kingdom Hearts 2 is my favorite game of all time, if you guys didn't know that. And they were originally a PlayStation exclusive game. Now they are both Xbox and PlayStation. Obviously, the all-in-one Kingdom Hearts game and Kingdom Hearts 3 came out for Xbox, that was like 2 years ago, for Kingdom Hearts 3. So now I can feel like I can play any of them, but a lot more of my friends play PlayStation nowadays, so I usually just stick to PlayStation now. And then obviously I really love, like, I really hope any PlayStation friends out there, they make a new Infamous game. I really loved Infamous Second Son and all the Infamous games before. It's one of my favorite PlayStation exclusive series that they have. God of War obviously is a really good game as well. And yeah, I like the sort of, I love the controller, I love the fit, I'm very much used to the X, square, triangle, circle vibe of everything, so it's just what I'm used to. But yeah, like I said, I actually wouldn't mind getting an Xbox if, like, it ever came around that I could get both systems, which I doubt that will ever happen, but if it ever did, I think I would definitely do that. I would definitely get both. And then again, there's the whole opposite sort of argument of just, hey, why not just cash in all this money on getting, like, a gaming PC or something like that, which, honestly, it's been another really big thought in my head. It's just, for me, it's just, like, when you get a gaming PC, like, it's just so much extra work. Like, you gotta obviously build it, never buy a pre-built PC, always build your own. That's the always biggest thing, you always gotta build your own PC. But then there's, like, you know, you gotta get a chair for it, and you gotta get, you know, the whole sort of setup in the desk, and you have to find a place to put everything, and, you know, it gets very complicated. Then you have to start learning all these new things. Obviously, for some people, it's very easy. There's some sort of, you know, really, really smart tech wizards that are just like, what do you mean? That's just second nature to them. But at least for me, I haven't had a computer in a very long time. I used to do everything on tablet and things like that. So I think it should still just be a lot of fun to just have one. Obviously, like, streaming-wise, I would love to be able to stream for you guys. I've always wanted just to try out doing a live stream with you guys, just sort of sit down, maybe talk basketball, talk video games, just talk with you guys. I think that'd be a lot of fun, but I don't know, I just feel like my I don't have a big enough platform. I think there'd probably be like 3 people in there if I'd ever try to do a live stream, so I might test one, do like a little, like, out of nowhere, out of the blue test live stream at some point in time. I think that'd be kind of fun. But as for, like, Twitch and gaming and stuff like that, yeah, I would love to be able to do that, but maybe eventually down the road, once I start, you know, if I ever do start, you know, growing on YouTube, I would definitely love to do that. I think it'd be a lot of fun, because I'm on Twitch all the time watching, like, Los Polos, XQC, Mizkif, Greek God. Like, I watch, like, a lot of those sort of community guys, so, yeah, I think that'd definitely be a lot of fun. But anyways, so, yeah, the main consoles for next gen, I really, really, really hope I can get my hands on one, especially not just for my own entertainment, but for you guys. I think for you guys, it's a more bigger deal. Like, I can wait. I don't care if I don't see a next gen console for, like I said, till the next year, or, well, not the next year, but until, like, the new year, you know, January, February. I think I'd be fine. I could wait. But for you guys, I want to get you guys, like, the best up-to-date content as possible. And I just feel like I'm not doing that for you guys. So, like, I really do apologize if you guys are sort of waiting on that, or seeing other sort of streamers and players sort of do it, and then you're waiting for me to do it. But like I said, I'm not some sort of big content creator, can just get one out of the blue. I just can't do it. So I will eventually, but I guess we'll just have to see when. But I guess now we can, I guess, start talking about some of the upcoming games that I'm very excited to be playing. Yeah, for next sort of games, I really want to start not only playing for myself, but also for you guys, is obviously the biggest one on the list is Spider-Man Miles Morales. I originally played the, you know, other 2018 maybe, on my channel. You guys loved it. I think that video has like 5+K views on that video, so you guys are obviously big fans of Marvel, and obviously I am too. I've done a couple videos on, you know, Marvel videos, you know, the Spider-Man video, I've done the Avengers game video, I've done just talking about Marvel superheroes video, I've done a movie sort of collection video, so obviously you guys know I'm a big Marvel fan. I'm hoping to make that like a full length series with you guys. I think that'd be definitely a lot of fun. Also, next, probably on the big list of games that you all probably want me to play is Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, which is a game that definitely looks like a lot of fun. Obviously, I've seen the homie, the boy, the absolute legend, ASMR Collective play some of the games for it. Zombies look a lot of fun. I've heard the multiplayer is actually kind of trash right now. The game is sort of buggy, so I'm not entirely sure if I should even pick that one up yet. That's why I'm sort of leaning more towards Spider-Man, also just because I feel like it's more of an ASMR type of content video for you guys. And then maybe after that I'll do some Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Definitely excited to maybe play a campaign level or two for you guys as well, but obviously the big boy is the multiplayer and the zombies, which I think that'll also be a lot of fun. Man, I haven't played zombies in a hot minute, like a very long time, so I'm definitely very excited to jump into that, and that'll definitely be a lot of fun for sure. I'm not entirely sure how good the campaign is. I haven't looked at like anything of it. Again, I don't like spoilers for myself, so I'm sure it's gonna be a lot of fun. But maybe let me know, like again, about these sort of video games. Let me know what you think of these games, your experiences with them. Just don't spoil anything, obviously, in the comments for me and other people's sake. Let's see. Assassin's Creed Valhalla, a game I've pretty excited to play. I'm not really entirely sure about all these sort of newer Assassin's Creed games. I really, really, really enjoyed Assassin's Creed Odyssey. That was probably my favorite Assassin's Creed game for a long time, actually. But for an Assassin's Creed game, it was dog duty. I didn't like it at all. The game should have just been called Odyssey or something like that, and that game would have been awesome. It would have been so much fun. But the fact it was an Assassin's Creed game, it felt nothing like an Assassin's Creed game. An Assassin's Creed game hasn't felt like an Assassin's Creed game in a very long time. I know they had the Egyptian one. That one was trash. I didn't like it at all. They've had some other ones throughout the years. There was one where you played in, like, England. And that one was okay. And I'm not entirely sure how this one is going to be very Assassin's Creed themed, but I could feel this game is probably going to be a lot like Odyssey, which is good. I'm going to enjoy it probably, but the fact that it's an Assassin's Creed game, but it's going to be nothing like an Assassin's Creed game, is going to make me very upset. Obviously, we all miss the days of, you know, Ezio Auditore and all those guys. I really enjoyed the American Revolution one. That one was a lot of fun. I played that one on Xbox 360. There were a couple other pretty okay ones, but I really enjoyed Odyssey, and I think I'm going to really enjoy this one as well. But they're just going to not really correlate in my mind, at least being Assassin's Creed games. They're just going to be more just standalone games. But I'm very excited to play this game as well. Watchdog Legions, a game I'm very excited to play. Actually, I played this game a little bit, and I actually recorded a video for this game. But A, I didn't know if you guys really wanted me to play this game. B, it's a pretty interesting game, that's for sure. It was okay. But thirdly, I think it's just more of like a filler video I have just in the back, just because, just in case I can't film for a day or need something to film and put up right now. It's a like little bit of a back burner video, but I do have an actual video of, you know, me playing Watch Dogs Legion for a little bit. I only had it for a little bit, but it was definitely a lot of fun. Godfall for the PS5. I actually have no idea what this game is even about. Definitely let me know how you guys think about this game. Right now it's rated, and I'm seeing it a 6.2 out of 10, which doesn't look that great. I've sort of correlated this game being a lot like a sort of Bloodborne, or Dark Souls type of game, where it's very, you know, a lot of 1v1 action. action and a lot of dodge roll and things like that. So if that's the case, I'm not good at those games at all. I suck a lot at like Bloodborne, Dark Souls type games. I'm not very good at them at all, but I feel like this game looks pretty interesting, at least for sort of a launch title for the PS5. Oh, this one could just be, at least for myself or any, if there is any Kingdom Hearts fans who watch my videos, Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memories came out a couple months ago, actually, and in my opinion, please God, do not buy this game. Do what I did and just watch the cutscenes on YouTube. It only takes you like an hour. The game is basically just like a Guitar Hero style game, but with Kingdom Hearts music, which is awesome, and I'm definitely going to buy this game. Not at full price, so I'll buy it when it's like 15, 20 bucks. Definitely for sure, because I obviously love Kingdom Hearts, but bro, it's crazy that they're selling this game for so much, and it's just not what it should be at value. It's just a very pricey Guitar Hero style game. Now, I've seen the cutscenes, and don't get me wrong, please go watch this cutscene scenes and the, you know, and movie stuff. If you're a big Kingdom Hearts fan, for sure do that, but please do not spend your money on this game right now. Wait for it to go on sale or something like that. It's definitely not worth the full price, at least in my opinion, and I'm a humongous Kingdom Hearts fan, and I still feel like it's just not worth it, so that's just a little hint for you guys. Obviously, NBA 2K21 on next gen is probably, again, the game I'm probably going to buy first if I ever do get my hands on one on a next gen console, but I'm super excited about it now. Don't get me wrong, I know I'm not, like, buying a PS5 just to play NBA 2K21. God, no, I'm not that dumb. I'm definitely more excited about a lot of other games and content for the PS5. That's for sure, but obviously, 2K being a big part of my channel, it's definitely something I'm sort of prioritizing, for sure. I'm very excited to do the sort of whole, you know, my team park sort of vibe. I'm hoping to get back on that. I can't do it on PS4, I don't like the game, like, it's just not fun to me, and honestly, 2K in general is just, it's just different, the vibe, it's just different. I love doing rebuilds, rebuilding is fun. I could do rebuilds for every video if I really wanted to. I love doing rebuilds, but it's just, like, the actual gameplay is pretty meh. The My Career story mode was dog duty. That was the worst one I think I've ever played in a couple years. Like, that wasn't a fun storyline whatsoever, pretty bland. And then the My Team is good, and it will get better once the season pops off and there'll be more, you know, things to do and more cards dropping and things like that. And it's definitely been the best part of 2K, I think, in my opinion, is the My Team. But it's just so early on in My Team, like, Amethyst cards are so expensive still, and it's just, wait a month and there's a whole batch of new cards that are way better than the ones that just came out a few weeks ago. So you just save your money and wait till the end, like I did last year. You guys really enjoy this video, so I think I'm gonna be doing that again for this next gen of My Team. So I'm excited about the look of 2K. I'm excited about doing my league and rebuilds on the next gen 2K. But other than that, I'm not, you know, head over heels about it. Let's see what's going at coming soon. Obviously, Cyberpunk 2077 is one of the biggest sort of games coming out, hopefully, this year. I think it got pushed again to December 10th of this year. It was actually supposed to come out this month. I think even before this video was coming out, it should have been out already, sometime in November, but I was very excited to play this game, and I still am, but God, I hope when this game comes out, it plays good, because, dude, it might be extremely buggy, it might be, you know, extremely bad when it first comes out, it might, you know, be a Fallout 76 2.0, like, it just might be totally bad. So, fingers crossed. I have a lot of faith in this game, the developers and everything like that. I'm very, you know, I'm happy that they're taking their time on it, but I hope it's not because of, like, there's a problem or something like that. So I'm just very, 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 very cautious about this game for sure. Again, a game I've never really looked into a lot of, because I want, again, that sort of surprise factor when I play it, but I know it's sort of like an open world, sort of futuristic style, technological, advanced sort of world, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I really hope it's sort of like a very RPG-style game where it's very customizable and you get to create a character and things like that, but I don't know if that's true or not, but I think that'd be a lot of fun, and it being open world, or some of my favorite games of all time are just open world games like that, so I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Let's see, what else? Yeah, so we just talked about Cyberpunk. I'm trying to find more games that aren't just... So I did play, if you guys saw the new Star Wars Squadrons game, that game was dog duty. I said it before, I'm only really going to play the game for a little bit just because I love Star Wars, and it was fun for a little bit, but it gets so repetitive, you know, and I think the gameplay is nice, but not spending a whole whopping, you know, $50, $40, $60 on a game where you're just sitting in a sort of starfighter and shooting things in space, it's just, it wasn't that fun to me, in my opinion, so yeah. That's for sure. It wasn't anything super crazy. Newest releases maybe for Xbox. I think they're all probably the same as the PlayStation. Yeah, they're all pretty much the same as the PlayStation. I think we already sort of just ran through all of them. Actually, let's look at maybe some for like the next gen consoles. Coming soon maybe. This new Devil May Cry 5 Special Edition coming out. That'll be kind of fun. I think I've only played one or two of those before. There's actually not a lot. I think we sort of just ran through everything. There's obviously Demon's Souls, which is sort of like a Dark Souls type of style game. And again, I'm so bad at those games. I'm just not very good at them. But yeah, guys, I think that's gonna do it for me. I think that's all I really wanted to talk about. It's just sort of like the next gen style of gaming. My plans for it. Games I'm very excited to play. Let me know down in the comments games you're excited to play. Games you've been playing recently. You know, trying to wait to get a sort of next-gen console, or if you're trying to get, you know, a PC, let me know, or if you're just waiting around and waiting for prices to drop, that's probably the smartest decision to do, honestly, so, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Like you guys know, I like to create a total package on this channel. It's just a lot of my interests, and I really hope you guys sort of vibe with that as well. Obviously, sports is a very main concept of this channel, but at the core, it is an ASMR channel at its core. Be an ASMR channel about anything I do, traditional ASMR, gaming, sports, basketball, different things here and there, so I'm very happy that you guys can vibe with me as well and sort of just relax to these sort of different topics. Yeah, guys, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you liked the video, make sure to like the video and subscribe.